So do we need to call a marine biologist or something?
No, officer, this is no shark.
Valentine?
Exactly. The butler did it.
But Fred, how did you know?
I may be tired, but I'm always aware of my surroundings. I could tell from Bellington's nervous body language that he didn't want us in the house. Specifically, he didn't want me in that particular room. I recognized famous actor Jack Landale next door looking paranoid about his privacy. Only my window had a clear view of him. And Bellington clearly didn't want me to notice.
Exactly. Charlie Potts wanted to get a picture of Landale to sell for a fortune. He offered me a percentage to take a photograph, but I refused. He'd offered Bellington the same deal before, and he took it.
Unfortunately, getting the photograph of Landale proved difficult. Landale closed his curtains and used secret passages to come and go unseen.
That's why Bellington decided to use the legend of Dorsalfoot to scare away all the paparazzi competition and buy more time.
There was clearly a mystery you guys were trying to solve. But since you thought I was too far gone to trust, I had to improvise. What you didn't know was that Bellington was listening to your plan, so he was able to avoid the trap. He wasn't so lucky with mine.
Bellington, why'd you do it?
I am a butler, Miss Blake. It's in my genes. Plus, you know, money.
Oh, yeah, of course, money. I get it.
Totally justifiable.
Fred, I apologize for not trusting you. Not telling you what was going on put you, as well as all of us, in danger.
Welcome back, real friend.
Now it's time for you, Fred Jones, to get some real rest. But not in that room. We're not supposed to be in there, and honestly, it's been driving me crazy, so...